What's up, it's Jeff sitting with Ash here. We just want to do a little quick response on the Decoy video that you didn't tag out. So, what's your relationship at the moment with Decoy, Ash?
Up until I saw that video, it was pretty bad.
Yeah.
Now I've seen that video, it's even worse. Fuck him.
Bottom line, what happened with the business that went down in 2007? Just a quick explanation for the crowd.
That's when we started doing battle rap in front of video cameras. We did the World Rap Championships. We've done before, we've done DVDs, but we did the World Rap Championships and the qualifiers down there, so I met Decoy, and there's cool people, Dragonfly, Broadcast, so we did the Decoy was cool, so it was Chase. Decoy and Chase were real cool, we battled them first, sucked, all four of us just didn't know what to say to each other. And then, next battle did a bit better with Shag Peach. I had a little tiff with Annika, kind of at the same time. I was a bit younger at the time, so kind of ran up for the mouth a lot. And I told them to go, there's a picture, not that many people came to the game, some shit.
Sure,
just trying to get to the middle of it. You battle something, you always go battle the best, and there we are. Yeah, like, what's the point of battling and stuff? You know, shit, even the other shit is wrong, it's just a fucking shit battle. You know, like, battle someone good. So, that was my focus, but my relationship with it now is I feel it. Corners, pussies, saying that he's mad up in the storm. He knows that if he was in front of us, he wouldn't be talking like that. And he didn't talk to us like that in front of us. Or in the
other. Sounds like an internet war tonight.
I just get so much straight about the internet too. Let's get this straight. If you've spoken to me on the internet in the last 2 years, you're not talking to me now. Yeah, you talking to me, talking to probably bipolar, some dude who said, my God, I'd love to catch up with him. Dude, if you want to catch up with Chance sometime, let me know. I owe him, he said, he keeps me relevant when I disappear for 2 years at a time. But fuck that, like, he's going to hear about, you know what I mean? Like,
I think he's your biggest fan, to be honest. Why is
Zoned
out so salty?
Salty?
What exactly did he call him? I mean, Decoy can't seem to recall.
Yeah, he called him Shrek-looking fuck. Shrek-looking fuck. You know, it wasn't supposed to be no punchline, nothing. Zoned out talking. I told him that he stole his eyes from a character from A Bug's Life from the Battlegrounds. Well, you know why he's salty? Because of that situation, you said it yourself. Because you went and made a post on rapmusic.com, we're going to put the link here, click this link, if you really give a fuck, I don't care. You care, please say, read it, and tell me you wouldn't be offended if you were in that situation. Sometimes, you know, I've been in that situation too with my family. As soon as, you know, the daughter came out, I was like, fine, it's a fuck, I don't know, maybe I'm fucking cheap. And I've lost my job as a bouncer. So, you know, you go from like $1,000 a week income to whatever you need your hands up. Because I know in situations in someone should be met with. So, you know, this is in the short. You don't tell anybody about shit. You know what I mean? Like, what's it prove? Like, why are you asking for fucking charity? You know what I mean? Like, where's the money from the fucking company?
You know, where
are the sponsors? Let's go into that. All right. I wrote a proposal for like CEO's business. We have this business on it. Super shout out Fast Pass, it was fucking awesome. Val up here is my dude, you know what I mean? I worked for him a long time ago.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, you know, well, from hands. Yeah. From Adelaide, just going to Sydney. Gary knows. People know.
Yeah.
Fucking down there, right? So, especially when I know we do these proposals, Fast Pass to get behind us. Give us a little bit of cash. Bring some Americans over, fly the best around, give some justice and say, well, I want to pay justice. I want to pay him, I want to pay him, but everybody deserves to be paid on this stuff. You know what I mean? But, you know, finances are tight everywhere. It's quite happy to have it. But, let's get back to it. He's telling me that, he told us that he swiped pay. Yeah, what happened was, I gave up battle rap after the 60 battle. That's why I referred to his hand.
Yeah.
I don't battle rap anymore. I rap. And, he wanted me to get back into it. And I had said to Cursor at the Melbourne battles, I will battle you next. I got frustrated with the incident after the zone down frustration. Little thing happened. I wanted to crush him. And I could. I fucking could. You know, I know it's something that's sexy. I'm not stupid. I'm not delusional. It's something that's sexy. It's something that's angry. It's just a little bit of something that goes in there. Because Gerson would get me in a mode where I would just, write, you know what I mean? Like, in the past, I used to, I used to have ideas of just freestyle. There's so much about freestyle. I want to freestyle, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
But then I got 60 to help me write my verse to Gerson. I was a little bit of a notion.
Yeah.
Oh, fuck, no, I need to get some funny jokes in there too. But I can have that Gerson.
Yeah.
Yeah.
You calling that Gerson?
No.
No?
No. No. He wants me to battle him, so it's so much more funny if
I'm
going to say no.
I think the crowd wants to.
No,
wants to see that.
I've spoken with really, I'm really, really sorry to real talk for not showing up. It's the battle we had before when I was down there. That was fucked, man. Like, that was beyond my control. Couldn't make communication, that's what it said. And at the same time, the shit that happened with Decoy, he just went, fuck, battle that. We had nothing to do with it. Anything.
Yeah.
That's what it was.
Yeah.
And then, he's talking about these flights. He's, really offered to pay for his own now to go down. This was after Decoy and Pitts had left. Because we said, we're not paying to go to fucking Adelaide. 1 month after we've just flown to fucking hell, really can't. You know what I mean? Like,
yeah.
I get these $60 flights.
Yeah, yeah.
You know what I mean? It's like $500 a piece. You know what I mean? You're paying money to go to those places.
Well,
you know, I know now things have changed. Like, I've been offered this thing, which is great.
Yeah.
It's fucking awesome. But at the time, we paid our way. That's what we did. And Decoy goes, oh, yeah, you know, well, fucking, I can't expect you to run that bill. Because you need a financial situation. That's why I could expose his own doubts.
Yeah.
You know, the only thing he exposed of mine was my phone number, my phone email, my Facebook, everything that. Everybody knows I was Ash Woods. That's my name, Ashley Woods. Ash Woods was my Facebook. I was in Keynote. Keynote is one word, the Keynote speaker. Yeah, fucking hell. If you're going to attack someone's name, look at the picture, figure out what it means. Think of something funny. Think of something funny. How do you know that? Do you know what I mean? Like anything. Like, you know what I mean? Like keynote. I'm not gambling. You know what I mean? Like,
yeah.
Anyways, actually, what's
so
on Facebook? It doesn't exist anymore.
So what happened to the
I went fishing. I went fishing and said it was funny. I was getting calls a lot. Is this Peter? No, it's Ash. Oh. Who's this Keynote? Why? You know what I mean? Like, you never know who the fuck I am, why you call it.
But that's just not cool, though.
Oh, yeah. Fuck.
I mean, everyone's out in their grind. I mean, what other ideas did Decoy have to make a little bit of cash on the side?
He told me, you know what would be a good way to raise some money? For you to get a flight down to Adelaide for the battle in person?
He told me,
go on ElvisHipHop.com, download 360's new mixtape, burn it onto CDs, and say, what ups? You know, 360's new CD, fresh, you know what I mean, not even on shelves yet, fucking right. And want me to hustle 360's music. Shout out to 360, I like that dude.
Yeah.
Don't get me wrong, man, I'm not here to talk shit about that. And 360's cool, but I'm not going to hustle his music.
No.
I make good music. Him, Pez, Dilly. I like a lot of music, and there's some of the guys that we actually like.
Yeah.
I gave him shit because of my fucking gay ass diss to fucking Lenny Miller's. What's it called? Norman Young.
Yeah.
You know,
I remember that, yeah.
It was an angles drummer, you know.
Yeah.
It is what it is.
So why couldn't you get in touch with
any of us? Because we didn't want to get in touch with us, as simple as that.
No excuses, no nothing.
What do you need excuses for, man? We don't. Nobody needs Jesus. Nobody. Nobody needs a lie either. You know, like we get to the point where Zach works away in a remote community. I've said it a million times. He works in a remote community. There's no service, no nothing. Right?
Yeah.
He comes back for a week.
Yeah.
3 days a week. He comes back in the studio.
Yeah.
And bam, he's off to work.
Yeah.
And he does the same thing. And so you're not going to get hold of him ever, especially not when you went and addressed a Facebook message with your vagina or stuff on your vagina, some shit like that. He saw that when he was looking off.
Yeah.
He saw 1 minute of Decoy's response.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
Yeah, we'll just wrap it up.
Have we covered anything? I think we have, man. No, what we haven't covered is, buddy, you telling me that I'm a pussy and you telling me that I make you stomach like a man, we are both in Liverpool with you. I don't know if anyone cares, then what's up? Who should care is Gary McCammer, whatever the fuck is that?
Say it, man. How many times have practiced his name?
And his accent is Gary
McCammer.
We're both from Liverpool in England. So don't be fooled. In that O'Shea battle, when he turned around and went like that with his accent, he can do that. He's from Liverpool. You know what I mean? That's who you're fucking from. And where we are from, if you lie, you handle it. So this is what we plan to do. We plan to respond to you when we see you. And we will respond like that. You know what I mean? Like, I hope you can. I hope you can, because when he couldn't, when he got bashed in the city, me and Mikey, and the
that?
Yeah, man, we went all the way out there, 45 minutes.
Then you haven't forgot that.
No. You got bashed, you didn't. You were leaving a pub and got bashed. We told 10 dudes from the city. No disrespect to him, no disrespect to Camden, even to the family. But we told 10 dudes from the city. You're in Melbourne, and there's a hotel, basically a bunch of fucking bitches. And you were on the desk in the hotel. And here's what it is.
Here's what it is. Truth. Peace.